Hello, guys. I just wanted to come on here for a minute and talk to y'all about something. Well, I give y'all some suggestions too. But I'm trying to tie these into two topics. But I want you to know some things. Like the last video I made was about the children of God and the things they went through and different things. But let's get into a prayer before we get into that. Thank you, Father God, for waking us up this morning and blessing us to see a new day. Watch over us and guide us and guard us and protect us throughout this day, Father God, and lead us throughout this day. I pray that you come through me at this moment in time, Father God, in order to give the people absolute truth. And I pray, Father God, that you let the Holy Spirit come through me at this moment in time, Father God, in order to give the people absolute truth. And I thank you for listening to this prayer, Father God. Amen. Now, first I'm going to get off into this first, right? I'm going to give y'all this because I don't want to take it to another different level. Because I want you to know the things that you're in and the things that you're doing. If you are of God and you're probably Christian or whatever, even if you're not Christian or whatever it is, you have to come out of sin. Okay? I have to repent daily and every day for the sins that you don't know that you sin, you know? But these are some of the things that you should know so you will know it. And I will give y'all these things on when I do other things, you know. I'm not going to tell you right now, but you'll see. Right now, I want you to know that the things that you do and the things that you're eating, the ways of how you're living and things like that, it is of sin. And this is why a lot of people don't like me. But I don't care, because I'm going to give you the truth. You have to stop drinking. You have to stop smoking. I'm not going to sit here and lie to you. Now, some people might say, I think as a Christian, I think you could just have a drink. No. No, you can't. You can't. For we don't drink. We don't smoke. I'm not a Christian. I'm just of God. See, that's another thing, too. You got to come out of that bondage of placing a religion on yourself, which is a religious spirit. Okay? And that's what people got to understand. I'm spiritual. There's only a few in this world that know these things. I just happen to be one of the child of God's. And but I'm here to talk to you about coming out of sin that you don't know that you be in sin. For you thinking that you might have a drink or something after church, or which is weird. But after churching or after wherever you're coming from, you're not supposed to be drinking, period. That is of sin. Drinking is of sin. That's why God changes people and prep people and prune them to come from under, away from those things. You understand? You're not perfect. But you can definitely try and get there. To at least try and get halfway or something. Smoking. Now, I know these things are not going to be easy. But it shows that you want change in your life. Don't supposed to be smoking. Anything, I'm going to tell you like this. Anything that's toxic to the temple and that's that tears down the temple, it's a sin. For the Holy Spirit has to dwell in here. You understand? The Holy Spirit has to dwell in this vessel. So it has to be pure. Your mind has to be pure. Your spirit has to be pure. Your body has to be pure. Even changing the way of the ways you eat. But some people don't think that eating meat is a sin. Meat tears down the body. And I mean tears it down. It wears it out. That's why some people just don't live, you know, past the age that they're supposed to live. Do you know that when you remove meat, that you get all your energy back, all your power back? Not only that, that it expands your life to 5 to 10 years ahead of time. I mean, 5 to 10 years longer. Because meat clogs up your energies, it clogs up your bloodstream, clogs up your veins, it clogs up your mind frame. It blocks things in your mind from being able to get to, you know, blood getting the form to where it's supposed to flow the right way so that you can know the things of God. you have to, like, start eating you some fruits, some vegetables, some grains, some nuts, and some fish. I teach about these things. And switch your meat out for fish. And start trying to eat right. Eat everything. I'm not going to say eat everything organic, but mostly, yeah. Eat everything that's plant-based from the ground, from the root. Okay? Bananas, fruits, you know, fruits is very good for you. Fruits is nutrition to the body. How can I say this? Don't be eating all that junk food, things like that, like the snacks. If you're going to eat a snack or something, let it be some bread or some raisins or some crackers or something like that. Some crackers and cheese or something like that, you know. Nothing that's just going to, like, deteriorate the body. Crackers don't, you know, mess with the body. You know what I'm saying? Cheese, it kind of don't mess with the body. It's really not supposed to be eating dairy products either. But I try and make a supplement for the cheese, you know. I don't think we're supposed to be eating cheese either. I don't know, though. But I eat cheese, you know, every blue moon. But eat you like some crackers or something like that instead of eating chips and cakes and junk food, things like that. Remove those things from off your item. Those are all toxic things that keeps you low vibration. And when it keeps you in low vibration, when it keeps you there, it keeps your body in a very deteriorating state. A lot of people don't know these things are tearing the body down. And these are things that are toxic, and these are the things of the wicked for us that they made up, man-made, okay? So, this is why I was telling you. Now, That's one time. I want to get into it the other time. What if, I don't know if I should tie this topic into to this topic here. No, I don't think I want to tie this topic into this topic here. And I'll just come back on with another topic. Yeah, I'll just come back on and do another one. But get you some start eating things that's fruit for the spirit. Change the way you think. It starts to change the way you think. Start meditating more. It changes your energy. This ain't gonna be a long video, so I ain't gonna tie the topic in the same story. It's not gonna be a long video. And I'm gonna come back on for another one. Now, get your fill your house with organic things, okay? Eggs, plants. Plants and things like that. These are things that you have to, you know, stay away from all the junk food. Stay away from all all the toxic things. Okay. So, all right, when these things go about. Mess with me at this moment in time, guys, so y'all bear with me. Come away from the drinking, the smoking, going out to the club saying, oh, I'm gonna go to the club, and you're supposed to be a child of God. We don't do those things. We don't do those things. You get into that word, you get into some fasting, you get into some praying, you get into some, if anything, do you some reading and writing. Educate your mind more, read you some books. You know? Don't be on this video thing, YouTube, like this. if you're gonna watch somebody, watch a person. Stay with one, don't, you know, but also use your discernment and ask God, is that person is of you? You know, so he will let you know that, yeah, he's of me, or no, he's not of me. Move away from that. Matter of fact, and cut it off. But I told you, like, these prophetic words, people don't need to be on there. It's not what you think it is. Instead of drinking juices and things like that, drinking some water, go somewhere and make you some tea or something, you know, things that's organic, with no nothing toxic, pops and all those you know, candy and all that stuff. That stuff is toxic to the body. It really tears down. Okay, so that you could be able to see and know the things that you want to hear and know from God. All right, you first got to start at the root. Start eating better. Once you start eating better and switching things, then you'll start seeing the change in your energy, in your mind frame, the way you think. Everything starts to change. Start by the food. Start by the food first, and then go into, you already will probably be doing, at the same time, do some praying and read your word. And also, if you ain't been fasting, try and do a little fast here and there, a day or two or whatever, just to get you started. with some fruit or something. Since it's your first time, do it with some fruit. But the fasting, do it with some fruit or some. Just switch your salad. Do some salads, you know, things like that. But it first starts off with the food first, guys. Okay? And once you start off with the food, then you can start with everything else. And then you'll see, you know, after that, things want to change, your energy and things, your mind frame shift, okay? So you'll know. But, yeah, I just want to come on here and let y'all know about these things. Get into some fasting, get into some praying, read your word, commune with the Lord, build a relationship, stay, you know, with him up and down. This is God's good news for you today. I thank y'all for listening to these messages, and y'all be blessed. Amen.